Hey guys, my name's Faye. Welcome back to another episode of the Dinosaur Mine. I'm really happy with this balloon. Can I just say that here for a second? I think it is a really, really nice little highlight up in the sky. Just what I intended. Alright, so today I'm going to work on this entrance hall. As you can see, I already started a little bit. Cut down a couple of these smaller trees there that are despawning right now. Laid down the first couple of tiles. But yeah, I'm out of marble. Our archaeologist is, by the way, doing fantastic. Haven't traded with him again, but he's fine. He had a couple of zombie visitors already, but they were all nice and lining up here. They must have been British, right? Wasn't it the British who really love standing in a line, queuing up for things? So they all stood here, were waiting to get served, and then they vanished. I didn't see them vanish, so they must have paid their prize and get into the museum. Although it's not even open yet. I don't know what happened to them. Anyways, yeah. So usually I do quite a bit of work and record afterwards what I've done. Today it's gonna be a little bit different. So I basically did no work since last episode. But I thought I started by recording a nice little clip and then get to work. And so you guys get a better feel for the progress that's happening. I think that's a good idea, I hope. We'll find out soon enough. So, I built a wall. So, and when I initially built it, I thought, I thought, this is gonna look way too plain. I gotta come up with something to spruce it up. But hey, look at it. Doesn't look bad. I kinda like it, actually. It looks a little bit like a dam. And a dam is something that I wanted to build for ages in Minecraft. It's on my Minecraft bucket list. Do you guys have a bucket list for Minecraft? Well, I don't really have a bucket list, but a dam is definitely something that I always wanted to build. Well, not always, but I definitely want to build at some point in Minecraft. I think it could be a fun project. Especially if you have like an artificial lake higher up in the mountains and you build a dam to keep it there. One of these days. I'm not sure if it's going to be in this world or in another world, but one of these days I'm going to build it. But yeah, this is how it is. This is going to be where the windows start. So this is just going to be plain stone. But as I just said, I don't dislike it. It's kind of cool. And I will probably build at least one more set of tiles here. There's three more blocks out here. Maybe another one, but then I only have two for the wall. Because I want to try something with the wall. I'm not quite sure what yet, but this is way too plain. So I might do some more exhibits here for something. Maybe for some skeletons. Maybe some skeletons would be actually pretty cool in here. I gotta be careful. I don't think there are that many skeletons. There's a lot of different stuff, but not too much. And we don't want to have like giant empty gaping areas in this museum. We have a lot of space to fill, as you can see. I guess over time we will be able to fill it more and more, but still, I don't want it to have an empty feeling or something like that. So I gotta be careful with what I do. I think once I build this entrance hall, I'm gonna call it the museum. That means that I won't build any more wings or extension like I initially planned. Of course, if we should be able to fill up the whole thing, we can always continue in this direction, as I mentioned last episode. But I think for now, I'm gonna keep it this way. I'm probably gonna end it. Is this a good place to end it? This might be. Maybe I should go. No. I think it's a good place to end. Because for every tile I go further out, I have to gather so many more resources. And yeah, I think I'm gonna end it here. Although it's kind of awkward. We have this. Maybe one more. Let's see where one more would let us end up. So we got a pillar here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We would have another one here. So this would be definitely alright from this side, and then there's still a little bit of a gap here. I mean, I could even just fill that in if I really wanted to. Other than that, it would go over here. Oh wow, it would go even further. So yeah, I think I'm gonna actually make it one more. How many tiles are this? Is it then? So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That sounds like a nice number, doesn't it? So I think that's what I'm gonna do. You know what I might do? I might mirror the staircase design on the other side so you can get into this big hall from both sides. And there's no way in keeping it a secret. You guys probably guess what's gonna go in the middle. There's gonna be a really, really big skeleton. Probably a Brachiosaur. Brachiosaur was the one that was in this mod, right? The biggest? I think so. There is actually a museum in Frankfurt, in Germany. And this is a museum I visited several times when I was small. I think once when I was in elementary school. And at least one more time when I was in middle school, kinda, age. And I think I was there even with my parents sometimes. And this museum was always in my mind because it was like the dinosaur museum in my area. And there was just like that. There was a big hall with a giant. I don't think it was a Brachiosaur. It might have been a Diplodocus skeleton. But really, really big and really, really awesome. And this is kind of what I based it on. So just so you know where my inspiration is coming from for this entrance hall project. But yeah, now I think I'll just have to finish the floor and start working on the walls. And we're going to worry about the skeletons and everything where we're going to put something once the exterior is done. I have to put in the windows everywhere. And of course, I have to put in the other floors, which is going to take some time because I don't have too much quartz left. I think this is even all I have left already again. This won't even be enough to fill this floor down here. Oh man, what a pain. Great news, everybody. Got just blown up by a freaking creeper. And the worst part is, it happened right next to our all-time favorite archaeologist. And the really best part about that is, he was surrounded by two baby zombies and one zombie villager. So if even just one of these collapsible blocks is down, we can wave our archaeologist goodbye. And now I'm on fire because this day... Okay. I see things. We are safe. Wow. Look at that. Oh my god, this is good. This villager zombie now has my sword. I guess that makes him a new volunteer. But it looks like these collapsible blocks just barely stayed intact. This could have ended very, very badly. And this was just one time I didn't get to bed in time. That's what happens, kids. If you stay up too late, there's gonna come a creeper and blow your favorite villagers up. Because this is how life works, right? Man, this chisel flew quite a ways. Alright, I guess I'll be getting to repairing this stuff. Kind of want to keep this villager here because we can convert him later. I need to repair. It's not too bad from what I can see. Yeah, like this. And then we can have it like this. And boop. And oh, where's my pickaxe? Almost broken. Yeah, that should work. Where's my... Do I have... Wait. Okay, I have some stairs right here. Okay, so the repairment... Oops, that was a mistake. It's not too bad. I am a little short on... Oh no, I have some more marble. That's right, I found some stash in the lab that I haven't used from previous builds that we used marble for. Okay. I would call this... No! How? Was he through the corner? I guess this is what happens, man. Sorry, but if you hit my favorite villager, You're not gonna have a job here. I hate that these carpenter's blocks. Wait, did he take my sword with him? No, the small guy has the sword now. You know what? Why are we not using our new mega bow that we got last episode? Oh, that's why. Don't. You're trapped. There we go. Give me my sword back. Two durability. Yep. Totally worth it. Crap. Ah, oh, today's not my day. But then again, when is my day? It's probably never. Okay, let's fix this up. And everything is back to normal. Why is there no stone here? Oops. Ah, it's a waste, but it's okay. Okay, so our archaeologist is got hurt, but he's safe. However, I gotta do something about this corner. We'll maybe put some fences in or something later, but for now, this dirt will have to do it. So no baby zombie can attack him through the corners. But he stayed safe, which is the most important thing. In the meantime, I worked a little bit on the back here. Tried and work a little bit further out. I also finished the wall up to the front here. Yeah, up to here. And now I gotta turn it around and connect it back. And then I think the next thing I might do is get the whole walkway upstairs around in, yeah, including the staircase on the other side. And then we can see what else we want to do with this place. So I've been doing some roof work here, and I think I'm already completely out of stone again. It's just a struggle for resources, and I don't think it's gonna stop anytime soon if you look at that. Oh yeah, I don't think I showed you that. The floor is done. I built a staircase, at least half of it, until I ran out of marble again. It's big. I told you guys. Told you so, but I think it's cool. I like it. I like it a lot. It's gonna be really nice. I'm not quite sure yet if I want to have it open all the way to the roof, or if I'm gonna have other floors above it. Yeah, still have to decide. Another thing I might want to do before we do anything else is I still haven't put the glass roof over our courtyard here, like I planned in the beginning. So we might do that. I put a bunch of glass into the furnaces in the lab. I don't think it's going to be nearly enough, but at least it will be enough to figure out what kind of glass we want to use for that. Because I'm not quite sure on that either. We'll have to try certain options and see if it works with the connected textures and all that kind of stuff. Did I do anything else? No, I think that's pretty much it. I read your comments of last episode in the meantime. You guys, of course, are right. Our friend is not an archaeologist. He sells the dinosaur bones. Totally survived that. So he is a paleontologist. And the best name suggestion for a paleontologist is, of course, Dr. Alan Grant, isn't it? So as soon as I get some name tags together, I think that's what we're going to call him. Would be a little bit of a weird job for Dr. Alan Grant to stand in a museum and just let people in. We might give him a better job later on if the time is right and if some job offerings open up. But yeah, I've been doing the work. All right, let's get to, not in the little pond here, let's get to the glass and check out what we can do with it. I always try to do something fancy with glass, but it never really works out the way I want it to. There are not too many different textures with it. And there are even less with stained glass, although in this case, I don't think stained glass would do any good. So let's see, here's a stack. Second stack, nothing. Third stack, nothing, nothing. Fourth stack, fifth stack. And I think I already put sixth and seventh stack in here. So we got quite a bit of glass. Oh, is it getting nighttime? Feels like it, huh? Let's sleep before we head out there again. Otherwise, I will end up being killed by another creeper. And we don't want that, do we? I hope you don't want that. Okay, we think we still have a little bit of time before we can sleep. So we got these options. A lot more than for the glass panes. The problem is, I believe most of them will simply connect and then will be mostly invisible. like these guys, for example, and the ones that don't really connect, where you still have the pattern, like these ones, I think they're just going to be too busy and are going to obstruct too much. I want to be able to see the sky still. You know what I could do? I could do something similar to what I did with the floor patterns, where I used 2x2 using the connected textures of different styles. So I could, for example, use the shale glass and the stone frame glass and then alternate the textures, and this way they won't all connect and just be completely see-through. Instead, we can have some sort of struts in between. But I don't know how this would look, because big squares of glass? Not really what you would expect for a glass roof. Another option that I could do is put manual, like full block struts, maybe out of factory blocks or something, across. But I'm a little bit afraid that that would be too thick and would cover too much of the sky again. So I guess there's nothing left but trying some different stuff out. We got a new visitor for our second villager here. Yeah, you see that? I don't want to cover up too much of it, but at the same time, do I want to have an arch shape or dome-ish shape? Not really a dome, but you know, like having a little bit of an arch in both direction. I don't know if that would look good at all. I don't think so. I think I would rather try out to make it all flat, because this would give me another headache to get the curvature just right. Let's just try to find a nice texture, and then maybe once we figure that out, we can still think about adding some three-dimensional structure to it. Okay, where? Oh! That was my plan. But I think we can just get back to a ladder like that, and we can get back up here. Beautiful. So, what height? I think I said it before. I think I want to start it just below this one. Okay, how about we try the stone framed one? Let's try the stone frame one, and I'm gonna lose a lot of glass here, aren't I? How can I place a glass block below this? This is not gonna happen easily, is it? Crap. Can I reach something? If I jump, I won't make it. Oh, you know what? That would be a ninja jump. Can you oh, I'm really low health right now. I shouldn't jump at all. I'm gonna die. But jumping from here and landing there? Is this possible? Is this a possible jump? I don't know. Let's heal up and try it out. Although we could also try maybe get some dirt block down there at some point. This is not gonna happen, is it? Nope, no chance. Yeah, I gotta try this jump. Alright, what are your bets on? Am I gonna die? Am I gonna survive this? I think when I'm full health, I should survive it, possibly. I mean, I could just land on this window instead. You know what I want to try? Let's try this over here, because then the path to the ladder is not as far. Okay, ready? Oh! Missed it by one. Crap. Alright, I guess this is as good as it's gonna get. Let's just dirt bridge up there. Will it look weird? Yeah, this will connect like crazy. And we're gonna have these weird stripes in there then. How about we make... Oh yeah, 3x3 is what we had inside. So 3x3 should work for this too. Alright, now we got a starting point. I think the rest we can pretty much get done from up there. It's gonna look a little weird when you look out of the window on this floor. Maybe. Hard to say. But we need to try it. If we don't try it, we'll never know if it will look good or not. Okay. Let us... If we alternate it maybe with the, as I said, the shale. Let's see. I don't remember how that looks. That doesn't... Oh, crap, I don't have Silk Touch. I have a Silk Touch, but it might break if I use it now. All right, you're going to stay here forever now, or at least until I have another Silk Touch pick. Okay, but if we do it like this, we have... It's a little bit weird color-wise. But it might work. Let's do a couple of squares, and then we'll have to take a look at it from down below. If this looks good enough for our expectations, or if we have to lower our expectations a little bit, or maybe we come up with a better idea. Of course, as always, in case you guys have the most amazing idea ever, feel free to leave it in the comments. I'm a little bit worried right now because I don't think it's gonna even out, is it? So we got 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. How is this even possible? That's not fair. What do I have to do to get rid of this anomaly? Oh man, I don't have a Silk Touch pick. I can't even remove this stuff now without losing a whole bunch of glass. That's not nice. So this is the center, isn't it? This should be the center. And also, where's the center? The center here is a little bit different. Oh yeah, we have these four white. It's gonna screw us over royally. So, you know what I should do? I should start exactly in the center of this whole courtyard if I want to make sure that I don't have to get rid of any glass anymore, but that's not gonna happen. So I think I'll just have to count it out. You know what? Let me do some counting off camera and then we can talk about that stuff. Wow, it actually works out. So this dirt block at the end is the exact center, and I counted from here just 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and it fits perfectly. So we are fine in this direction. So I can basically start making this our center. So I would need one here, and you know what? This is not gonna cut it. I need one back there actually. And then I can, is this the stone one? This is the stone one. Let's put that in the center. Bam. All right, this should work out. If this is 3x3, I'm kinda gonna have 3x3 here, here, and here, and then a single stripe on the side. If even, I could even just leave it be and start it over here. Maybe make even like a slope. Oh, you know what would be really epic? To use all the way collapsible carpenter blocks and make it really just not even one block, just this really, really thin layer of glass. However, I don't think it's gonna look good because this will take away the connected texture feature. So we'll have really one by one squares all the way around, and I don't think it's gonna look good. But yeah, this should work. So you know what? I think I'm gonna put some work into this and see how far I can get. I might do some grinding again. You know what I should do? I should call it a day for today, like in recording time day, I mean. Do some AFK fishing overnight, get the name tag for Dr. Grant, and at the same time, get 30 levels, because AFK fishing gives me a lot of levels too, and then we can repair or enchant a new pickaxe. I haven't made up my mind yet. And then we can finish this up. Wouldn't it be awesome? I think it would be a good idea. So I'll see you in a bit. All right, AFK fishing has been done. We are up to level 55 for some reason. So what I did is I had it running overnight and it worked perfectly. I'm not sure if the chest filled up overnight, but when I woke up, I emptied it. I threw away all the unnecessary junk, and then I did some more AFK fishing while I was at uni in the lab. However, when I came back, I was in the game menu for some reason. I don't know what happened. Maybe another program on my PC popped up, and Minecraft usually goes into the pause menu as soon as that happened. I didn't see any pop-up or anything, so I was a little bit confused. But it seemed to happen quite early because I refilled it, and it seems like it only drained the first row of fishing rods. So the second run was not as long-lasting as the one that I got overnight. But let's take a look at the loot. Crap. I barely did get anything new. I think I think I had it. Yeah, this is new. So I think up to this point is how it was when I woke up this morning. And this is the new stuff. So nothing really. Well, a looting 3 book. I will never say no to a looting 3 book. Especially I think look at this book. I mean, this is the worst book. Infinity 1 and looting 3. What would you take? I couldn't decide. I would probably take the looting, actually, since I already have an infinity bow. But yeah, that's kind of a weird book. There are some good books in here. 3 name tags, though, that is something that will definitely last us for today. And now I gotta find a way to fill all the stuff back in my inventory. You know what? I guess I could just leave. Let's do this. Let's leave the string here, because I'm pretty sure we'll need it again next time when I do some AFK fishing. And this way we can take all the stuff with us. All right, 3 new name tags. That's not too bad. Some more would have been nice, but hey, I won't complain. 3 is good enough for me, at least for today. You know what? We have 30 levels, and then we have another 25. That means that I will probably enchant a new pickaxe. Although, maybe I should not. Maybe I should repair, because repairing is more expensive than enchanting a new one. And, you know what, let's check it out. I have the silk that with me, right? Yeah, it's at 1 durability. So we're gonna check it out, how expensive it would be to repair it. It will probably be something like 37 or so levels. And so we probably should do that, because it will be easier to get up to level 30 again later on. Why did I take 3 diamonds? I won't be able to repair 3 diamonds of it. Okay, let's see. Too expensive. 2 is already too expensive. 1 does barely do anything. You really? I'm at the stage where I don't think it's worth it anymore, guys. I gotta tell you, I think it is about time to try our luck again at a new one. Of course, we could be punished, but we need a new one sooner or later. These are just gonna get more expensive and more expensive every single time we try to repair it. So let's try for a new one, and if it doesn't work out, we can enchant another one soonish. All right, wish me luck, guys, and... Ah! Not too bad, since this is almost broken too. So we got a new working pick. But yeah, 5 levels short of the next enchantment. I really need another silk touch pick, otherwise I will be in trouble sooner or later. While I'm here, let me do this real quick. Bam! And... Wait, can we already name a villager? Can we? Or can we not? We need to try it. I'm thinking, because when villagers were introduced, you were not able to name them in a single player world, because you would all always access their trading inventory instead of naming them. They introduced it. Oh, I'm sorry, guys. I'm so sorry. I just forgot that we already named like a whole bunch of villagers in this world. That was like a 1.6 feature, or 1.5 even? I don't know, but in the beginning you weren't able to name your villagers because you always opened the trading inventory, but now the shift clicking worked for quite some time now. Hello, doctor. How you doing? So you got yourself a name. That's beautiful. I hope you'll survive the eternity, and I might trade with you a little bit more later on. Oh, I should have left the other name tags in the lab, because now I will be scared the whole time that I will lose. You know what I should do? I got so much new fish. I think I should open up Fabe's Red Fish again and cook all these fish so I don't have to eat these stupid melons anymore. That sounds like a good idea. Other than that, I don't know. I'll have to gather some more resources if I want to make some progress here, so not sure how far I'll get today. Haha, you know what? Never mind that. This episode is so long already. I totally didn't notice that it went on for that long. So hope you guys enjoyed today's episode. And Yeah, I think we're gonna have some more work to do around this museum. But I'm really, really happy with the progress we are making. So it will be done, hopefully before episode 200. It would be amazing, wouldn't it? Like having the grand opening, that would be so cool. Anyways, I hope you have a nice day, and I'll see you next time. And seriously, guys, don't be daft. Play some Minecraft.